Hi, it's time for another verb of the day. Today's verb is record. Let's take a look at some of the definitions or ways that we use this verb. The first way you might hear the verb record used is to mean to set down in writing. Maybe a more complicated way of saying write. Or to make some other type of permanent form that can be viewed later. So we're going to see lots of different examples of this, but this is something that many people do in their jobs on a daily basis. They're writing down things that were said, things that were done, and creating these writings that we can view or look at a later time. A second way you might hear the verb record used is to mean to show or register a measurement or result. We'll again look at some examples of that, but with this particular definition, I think of prior classes in sciences, particularly where there were labs, we were doing experiments and changing the temperature, adding more liquid of a certain type, and then writing down measurements based on what occurred. A third way to use the verb record is to mean to achieve a certain result. We'll look at one of those usages in my example sentences later. A fourth way you might hear the verb record used is to mean to convert sound or a performance into some sort of permanent form. So here you might think of bands. They go into a studio, they record or they make their permanent sound into audio files that we can hear later. We might hear the music on the radio, we might be able to download it and listen to it online, or if you're of a certain generation, you might have bought a cassette or a CD or something else. As that conversion from sound at one time to be heard and played again and again. You should know that record is a regular verb. To make the progressive tense, all we need to do is add ing to form recording. The past tense and participle forms of this verb are made by adding ed. The base verb, record, D ends in a D sound. So our past tense ending is going to make an id sound. We're going to add an extra syllable. Recorded. Recorded. You'll be happy to know I don't have any additional meanings or usages through phrasal verbs. So this is going to allow us to do some sample sentences. Today we'll focus on the imperative and the past perfect. Let's start with the imperative. Many times this label can be a bit confusing for people, but let's think of it as a command. So we're telling someone to do a particular action. When I think of imperatives, I think of parents talking to children. I think of teachers talking to students, bosses or managers talking to their staff or employees. So what's unique about the imperative is that there is not a stated subject. The subject in all of these sentences is going to be you. Could be singular, could be plural, doesn't matter. But the you is implied. So you can do this when you're speaking to someone, but you'll also see people do it in their writing. A good example of this, I think, is our recipes, where you see each individual step start with the verb because it's implied. You who are trying to make this dish, who are trying to cook, you follow these steps. So the other thing you should know about the imperative is that you can always soften it, make it a little kinder, a little nicer by adding the word please. You can put please at the beginning of an affirmative sentence or negative sentence. You could also put it at the end, but you do not need it in both places. So generally, for an affirmative sentence, you can just start with the base verb. Or, as you'll see in my example here, I've just tried to soften it, make it a little nicer. So, here's an example. Please record my times each lap. Okay, so here, maybe this is an athlete talking to his or her coach and wanting them to write down or make a written record of times as this person runs or swims, whatever it may be. Now, if I want to make a negative imperative, I can start with do not or the contraction don't, and then the base verb. Again, the subject is implied here, it's you. So someone might say, don't record me singing. This is a sentence I have said. I do not want a permanent record of this. I don't want people to be able to see it or hear it at a later date. I am not a good singer. You'll notice there's a black box where our yes and no questions are, and that's because there isn't a question form for the imperative. So you can only have affirmative or negative sentences. Now let's take a look at the past perfect. We tend to use this verb tense to note that something in the past occurred before a certain time or before another action. To make the past perfect, we're going to use the past form of have, which is had, and then we'll use the participle form of the verb. Here, it happens to be the same as the simple past tense. Let's look at an example. Public health officials had recorded 6 strokes when they decided to temporarily pause the Johnson & Johnson vaccine. This is a sentence I borrowed from a news report. If you follow the news, you might have heard this in the United States. We have 3 vaccines, but one of them we're temporarily not using to do a little investigation to make sure it's not causing injuries. Right now, there are nearly 7 million vaccines from Johnson & Johnson that have been given, and 6 people have had a stroke, a medical event after this, and they just want to make sure that it's very safe. So right now the chances are more than 1 in a million. But again, our government is looking out for our safety, and that's a good thing. If you want to make a negative past perfect sentence, what you're going to do is insert not after had, or you can use the contraction hadn't, and then use the participle form of the verb. The team hadn't recorded a win in 2 weeks before last night's game. So here, the verb recorded or hadn't recorded is going back to that meaning of achieving a particular result. So they had not achieved a win, or said another way, they had achieved only losses for 2 weeks prior to last night's game. Now, you can also make yes or no questions in the past perfect. To do that, you would start with had, then we'll have our subject, and then the participle form of the verb. Had she recorded her thoughts in a diary? This question might be asking if someone is writing things down, but some people make audio diaries, so they speak into something and permanently save their voice and thoughts about what has happened in their day, or how they're feeling, etc. Now, let's spend some time looking at some words that are related to our verb record. And the first word we're going to look at is the noun form of this word. When you look at the noun form, you're going to see the exact same spelling, but the pronunciation is different. So I've been using the verb record. Record. Hopefully you're hearing me put stress on the second syllable or at the end of the word. When we use the noun, we're going to pronounce it differently. We're going to put the stress on the first syllable. Record. Record. Hopefully you can hear me saying the first syllable a little louder and a little longer. So just like our verb, this noun can have a number of different meanings. One possible meaning for the noun record is a written piece of evidence about the past. Here's an example of one of many different ways this could be used. Let's look at his medical records. Okay? So this is probably going to be a collection of a number of writings. Each time a person makes a visit to see his or her doctor, maybe has lab results or lab work done, has an x-ray, all of that gets collected into this written evidence about medical events in the past. A second way to use the noun record is to mean the total of past achievements or actions of a person or an organization. Here's an example of what this means. The company has a great safety record. So, we don't know what kind of company it is, but many times you hear this used with transportation companies like airlines. So if the airline has not had any plane crashes, accidents that resulted in injuries of passengers, we might say the total of their achievements in getting people safely from point A to point B is fantastic. A third way to use the noun record to mean the best performance or most remarkable event measured. So many times with this definition, you're going to hear people use it in connection to sports and other achievements. Let's look at an example of this. She set a world record in the 100. Okay? Again, this sentence isn't so descriptive, but this could be referring to running or swimming. That's a common distance. But again, it's noting someone had the best performance, in this case, the fastest time. A fourth way to use the noun record is to refer to a thin plastic disc that has recorded sound on it. So for anyone who's a bit older watching this video, before there were CDs, there were cassettes. Before there were cassettes, there were records. And that's the sentence here. They love to listen to vinyl records. So if you think they're kind of like these big, black, round shapes, very thin and flat. And today, some bands still record and release records. It's kind of thought to be cool. Might produce a sound that's slightly different, or in some cases, better. The next word we're going to look at is the noun recorder. This can also have a number of different meanings. We're going to look at three of them. The first way you might hear this used is to refer to a person who keeps records. So our example sentence here, she's been the county recorder for 10 years. This is referring to a person's job or position. And in many, if not all, U.S. states and in counties and other divisions, you will see this position or even an office, depending on the size of the town or city, where people keep records. It can be marriage, birth, real estate records, etc. But that's their job, to maintain these written records. Another way you might hear recorder used is to refer to a very simple wind instrument that has finger holes but no keys. I included a picture of two of them down on the bottom of your screen. Hopefully you can see the yellow highlight there. So this is not a flute. Some people get confused because, again, there are no keys. A flute would have keys. But this instrument is sometimes used for young children to begin to learn to make and appreciate music. So an example of this in some schools, all second graders learn how to play the recorder. So again, music can help with people learning math and many other skills, so you might have even experienced something similar when you were in school and growing up. The last way that we're going to look at using the noun recorder is to refer to a machine for recording sound, pictures, data. Sometimes if a tape recorder is just shortened into recorder. So an example of that, they used a recorder at all family events. So I think this was commonly referred to as like home movies. It became really popular, I think 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s. Now that everyone had, or that many people have cell phones that have a recording function or ability, less likely to see cameras unless it's a professional who's doing the recording. Thanks so much for watching today's video. I hope you have a great day.